Hey YouTube, Rick Tells Plus here. I've got a DIY video here for you. I'm going to show you how to make terrarium vines out of twine, wire, silicone, and some leftover background mix. This vine that I'm going to show you how to make is actually going to be a shapeable vine. So you can put it in your terrarium and bend it however you want to bend it, like the ones you buy in the store for like 20 bucks a piece or whatever they are. This is actually quite inexpensive. The wire is fairly cheap. I've had this for a while, so I can't tell you how much I paid for it. I don't even know what gauge it is. It's not very thick, but this vine that I'm going to be making here is going to be either for my frogs or one of the anole tanks. So it doesn't have to be that thick, but this is probably thicker than what I need. So the first thing you need to do is decide about how long you want it to be. Here. So this is probably about, I don't know, 2 foot, maybe a little more than 2 foot. So what I'm going to want to do is cut my twine twice as long as the wire. I'm going to cut 3 pieces just to make sure it's going to be thick enough. I'm going to make a loop out of the twine at the end, just so I have a way to hang it if I need it. And then I'm going to take the wire and I'm going to twist it around. Going to hold my loop in place. And all I'm going to do is take the twine and I'm going to twist it around the wire. You want to make it fairly tight so it stays in place. That's why you need the twine to be twice as long as the wire. same thing at this end. I'm going to make me a little loop. Twist the wire around it again. Make sure you mash that tip down. It's going to be covered with silicone in background, but you still want to mash it down just to be safe. I'm going to trim off the excess. And that is the start of your vine. Now, rubber gloves are essential because you're going to be working with your hands in this silicone. The silicone that I recommend is the 100% waterproof, all-purpose 100% silicone. This is non-toxic to reptiles and amphibians. This is some leftover background mix from a terrarium that I made, and all it is fine coconut fiber, some coarse coconut fiber, there's some pine bark in here, and there may be some traces of some sphagnum moss and some organic dirt. So I'm just going to dump some of it out here. Gloves on. Smear it all around the rope. I'm going to mash some background mix on it. Really don't want the large pieces. It on until you're satisfied with the coverage you've got. Make sure you keep that loop open if you think you're going to use it. Okay, if you see any bare spots, all you gotta do is go back and dab a little bit more silicone on and add some more background mix. Okay. Looks good. Now all you gotta do is let it sit overnight to dry, and then go back through and brush off anything that's loose, because you don't want it falling into the tank later on. And that's it. You can bend it any way you want. Thanks for watching. Click the like, subscribe, whatever. You might want to keep checking back regardless, because I'll be doing a lot of DIY videos. I have a lot of animals to take care of, so try to save money any way I can, making stuff myself. So y'all have a nice day, and thanks for watching.